Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, today as we stand in the presence of the Lord, let us look into the inner depths of our heart. Honestly speaking, it is very easy to come and praise God and say words of worship. But the truth is, in our relationship with God, where do we stand? Our heart, has it been given completely unto the Lord? Who rules within the depths of our heart? Is Jesus only given part-time worship? Only a few moments we worship God, but at other times our hearts are far away from Him. And that is why the Lord Himself would say, "These people honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far away from me." These people honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far away from me. It is very easy to come and worship and praise God. But are our hearts far away from God? This is an answer only you and God will know. In front of the world, it's very easy to show a kind of spirituality that maybe no one reads into. But in the depths of your heart, only you and God will know. Are your hearts far away from God? Let's close our eyes. Let's offer ourselves to the Lord. What no one else sees, God sees. He sees the dark areas of our life. He sees the sinful areas of our life. He sees the filthy areas of our life. Ask pardon. Ask pardon for the times when you ended up just giving lip service to God, where your lips honored Him, but your heart was far away from Him. For those moments of sin, let us ask the Lord pardon and forgiveness as we say together, "I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy on us, Lord.
graciously hear the prayers of those who call upon you, we ask, O Lord, and forgive the sins of those who confess to you, granting us in your kindness both pardon and peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Kindly be seated.
The inner conflict. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, chapter 7, verses from 15 to 25. I do not understand my own actions, for I do not do what I want, but I do the very thing I hate. Now, if I do what I do not want, I agree that the law is good. It is no longer I that do it, but sin that dwells within me. For I know that nothing good dwells within me, that is, in my flesh. I can will what is right, but I cannot do it. For I do not do the good I want, but the evil I do not want is what I do. Now, if I do what I do not want, it is no longer I that do it, but sin that dwells within me. So I find it to be a law that when I want to do what is good, evil lies close at hand. For I delight in the law of God in my inmost self. But I see in my members another law at war with the law of my mind, making me captive to the law of sin that dwells in my members. Wretched man that I am, who will rescue me from this body of death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ our Lord. This is the word of the Lord. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 6, verses 19 onwards. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust consume, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will also be. The eye is the lamp of the body. So if your eye is healthy, your whole body will be full of light. But if your eye is unhealthy, your whole body will be full of darkness. If then the light in you is darkness, how great is the darkness? The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be the Lord Jesus Christ.
Your goodness is spread beyond.
brethren, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
We offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of reconciliation and praise, that being moved to compassion, you may both pardon our offenses and direct our wavering hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice, we acclaim. For us, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
Oh,
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of His death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope, Cardinal Aaron Carey, our Bishop, and Sebastian and Thomas, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleaded you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
In the love of the Father, let us pray the prayer Jesus so lovingly taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord Jesus be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a meaningful and loving sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away
the lamp of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, merciful God, that receiving in this gift the forgiveness of sins, we may be able, by your grace, to avoid sinning and to serve you with sincerity of heart through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah.